Again, there's no cam. You're getting a nice No Man's Sky image. Oh, I could change that. I could change that. Oh, where's my... Wait, hold on. I've got a... Which No Man's Sky image do I want? Where's my gallery? Where are they? Sorry, I'm getting distracted now. Oh, that's a nice one. Right. Oh, crap. What did I just do? It's in the OBS screens, so I need here. Sorry, I'm just getting waylaid by things now. I want that. Yeah, streaming OBS scenes. I like that one. Let's go with that one. The casting off and superimpose text. This is today we aren't playing. Why have I got a new tab? What was I going to do? Oh, Google Sheets. Yeah. So do you want it in Fallout? Browse. I quite like... What is it? Boom, there we go. Quite like that. That can be my background thing. Because I have to play this game, right? With the desktop showing. So that can be my cover up everything that I don't want seen. Get rid of that. Yeah, but yeah, I have no idea how Fridays were gonna go. God, Immortals Fenyx Rising, so I'm gonna get it finished on next year. Yep. Ah, man. Are you gonna try and find out what the toilet paper was for? The extra special toilet paper duty is going on. Yeah, that's a lot of toilet paper. Right. I think I'm okay now. So. It should all be fixed. I can see the game. However, I don't think I've got any music on it now. Not sure if you want to know. I've taken that long from the intro that the game at the menu is just fucked off. It's gone. There's nothing there. You should be able to hear it if it was playing, but it's not playing. I'm going to tap out that. Hey, Batharian Aiden. So I need to go get rid of that. Quick, in the game. Oh my god. Oh, shite. Which one after? Just on nothing. Actually, I don't know what I've got up there. Game's going to sleep? Yeah, it has. It's gone very much to sleep. Oh, dab 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 dab. Ooh, 3 days off for your weekend. Nice. He's off to the coffin. Yeah. You're gonna have to let me know how the sound is on this. Select profile to begin the game. Will this screw it up if I go? We'll just go with the first one. You have chosen the profile. Do you confirm it? Oh, that was game noise. I could have sworn this was bloody full screen when I tried it. Why is it? Oh man. You're getting an old ass ratio. I'm getting it stretched. But I'm alright. Dude's in a coffin. The Vatican, September 3. I didn't get arrested. You're too fast, game.
Is it the fear of death that is tormenting you?
The fear of suffocating, Monsignor. At Caporetto, a shell buried my
Caporetto?
Yurt.
I was the lone survivor. God spared your life. May he bring peace to your soul.
I know, Cam. I'm in a different room. So I've got a doorway right behind
After
me.
After my nightmare, I opened the Bible and read this passage from Isaiah.
Just to make it easier on my
Yet thou shalt be brought down to hell, to the sides of the pit.
Arno,
you use the Bible to interpret your dreams. Please, don't sink
Assassin's
to
Creed.
Superstition. Your Eminence, since God rules the world, nothing happens by chance. Everything is the expression of his will. Everything must have a sense.
This isn't the dude from the other two games.
Arno, your hunger for answers leads you astray. Please, let's get back to the matter at hand. The congregation is sending you to Vladoviste in the bishopric of Alba Iulia.
In Transylvania?
You what?
The region has just been annexed by Romania, has it not?
To be sure. They speak mostly Romanian there, as well as a little Hungarian and German. Three languages you know well. You will investigate the case of Martha Calugarul, a physician and scientist
Calugarul.
Who died a few months
okay.
ago.
And we're already investigating?
The postulator of her cause has presented solid arguments to justify a rapid process. Naturally, this mustn't influence you, but you know your duty, don't you, Mr. Devil's Advocate?
Ooh.
Devil's Advocate, promoter of the faith.
Got a choo-choo train.
Monsignor Briganti has entrusted me with a great responsibility. God help me be worthy of it. Will Martha Calugarul one day be counted among the saints of the Catholic Church? I hope so, but truth must prevail. My investigation must leave nothing in the dark.
Wow. Subtitles at the bottom will go fast as well. It works, it works. Right, what am I doing? This is my... God, this was like freaking sending out a Morse code signal. But it's flashing all the time. Let's look at my menus. Inventory. I have nothing. Storage. Oh my god, how many items do we have? Oh no! The zone reserved for orderly storage includes several pages. Click on the tabs to pass from one to another. No! How many items am I going to have? Gonna take me hours to do school through all the different combinations. The transit zone. Objects you collect take their place here. Don't let them just pile up in a disorderly mess, but arrange them in the storage zone. Oh, look at that creepy hand. Do I have to? Oh, can I go out? Oh, automatic storage. Ooh. Crucifix. You're holding the following object. Crucifix in precious wood. Bible. Open the book at random. Wait, click on the open the book at random button when it is blinking. It will discover wise words, sometimes even predictions, which are strikingly in tune with your situation. Click on the button as many times as needed until the icon stops blinking to make sure you do not miss anything. Objects and document located both in the document interface until the end of the game. Oh, because after that it explodes. 4x5x5. Yeah! No, 100 slots! What does one do with 100 slots? okay, and then the inventory as long as you keep the object. Can I observe the possible combinations? Oh jeez, a hideous number. I think it fucked up how that looked on my end. Observe. Bible in red. Consult the document. Is this the... Ooh, open the book at random. Oh jeez. Nevertheless, you were thrust down to the grave, to the recesses of the pit. Ooh, let me try something. Oh my god. Wait. Page. So that was on page. Page was it on? 1872 of 3353! proximity that did that. Oh! Oh, jeez. Did they actually have that many pages? And it looks like, did they just do the whole bloody Bible in it? Did they actually put the whole Bible here? Fuck off. Jesus Christ, come, omnibus. Roman numerals. Ooh, standard system. Ooh, nice. Free Bible included with every game. Page 1 of 2. Examples. Comments. The origin of Roman numerals to be found on the sticks that shepherds indent in order to count their herd. They first make one mark for each animal. When they reach 5, they bend the mark in order to have a handy reference point. And anticipates the V. When they reach 10, they make a cross. It is the cross. That's a good deal. Jesus Christ pleasures himself in the omnibus. Through a system of elimination, of repetition, there's a natural progression from the shepherd's method to the archaic non-positional Roman system, solely based on the additive principle. Later, a desire for wow, I'm not English in the day. Do I want to say concision? This is the adoption of the subtractive convention. So 9 becomes 9. Requires reading orientation. Some places will do that instead. Or for 8. Wait, what are we on? Oh yeah. 9. I must have left that about in the King James Version. Okay. Acquisition? What does it mean? I need your documents. Order of acquisition. Or alphabetical order. Sort by tag? By origin? How many documents are we going to get? That is cursed. It's like, someone stood on the keyboard for too long. Dialogues. Oh, do we get to see everything? Oh my god, how many pages are we gonna have? Look at my dude. That objectives. Feel lost, take a few steps in order to clear your mind, then review your objectives, but do not follow them blindly. Make room for a bit of surprise and improvisation. No, don't. This is a point and click game. We don't want to improvise, we just want to be like logic our way there. Investigate about Martha, was it Calugarul? Calugarul. Contact a parish priest, talk to him about Martha. Visit Martha's grave, and visit the dispensary where Martha worked. Ooh, big cross. You know what I'm going to do though? I'm going to save it because I haven't. New save? Did that work? It. Wait, hold on. Why can't I load a game though? I just saved it. Oh, there it is. So there's a train.
This is not the time to take the train. I still have things to do here.
Well, fine then. Oh, my pick's London. I may be. Look at this tree, there's nothing to it. God, remember in the second game, I got stuck for ages with the bloody, the werewolves that were, was it werewolves that were chasing me? And having to move furniture? Hey, Sentinel, how you doing? Look at this way or this way?
Before anything else, let's try to find that inn where I reserved my room.
New detailed objectives at any time, right click and press the objectives button. Ta-da! No, this is not... Oh wait, it's got the inn. Now you've added it. Windows. Where it came from. Can I leave? Oh shit, I should find the end though. I'm in the fucking wasteland. A TikTok following I did in Martha have towards someone from the Vatican coming to the middle of a transal nowhere just to visit or grieve. Tip, skip. Skip a line in a dialogue or a cinematic, press the spacebar. That's train station. Big ass dog. Oh, internet's patchy. Someone with their hand making a dog. Definitely better today. Is this? Foundation. Oh, Vesnesi? Foundation dispensary. So we found our workplace, maybe. A bell ring.
My lord, war has caused so much damage.
I don't even know what year it is. Because the game went through the subtitles. Or the location, date, and time details so fast that I didn't get what it was. Going about like I need to find stuff. I really don't at this point. Listen in.
That huge, brightly lit building must be the inn.
Of course. Post World War One, maybe World War Two. Tell them apart in the car. Yeah. Oh, what is that? Cogwheels? Ding ding. Ooh! Why have you got a bunch of... Looks like garlic leeks and something else. There's a room. Well, I can't do anything with that until it goes through there. That? Why are you having a scarf on the wall? Right, I want to look at your...
What a delicious looking basket.
Garlic.
I see the inn's kitchen lacks for nothing. Which, for that matter, is astonishing in this ruined country.
Everything but garlic and leeks. Ding ding. I want to do it again. Can I not press this repeatedly? God,
hello,
you look
ma'am.
Familiar.
I'm Father Arno Moriani.
Ah, you're the one who's come from Rome about Martha. Hello, Father. Your room's waiting. First one on the right at the top of the staircase. You already got a letter. I put it on your table.
Thank you, ma'am.
Hosanna, Father. Call me Hosanna. It's the name they christened me with.
She had drunk AI. She may be. Did you know Dr. Martha well?
Oh, yeah. Really well. She saved my kid, you see. He was real sick. She sent him to the seashore. The doctor put
to
it
drown?
Like this. Hosanna, your boy's got to change climates. And if it'll make the difference for you, I'll pay the expenses. That woman was truly a saint. I often go pray on her grave. Oh, yes, one thing. Young Master Peckmister told me he'd sure like to meet you.
Mr. Peckmester?
To sell sheets.
Janos Peckmester. He's one of my lodgers. He got the room across from yours.
Peckmester.
He's in the parlor right now.
Very well. I'll go say hello now.
I am going to make parentheses towards your face.
Can I do something for you, Father?
No, thank you.
Oh, Rosanna. Just entertain me.
I don't need anything for the time being. There's no point.
Oh, ruining my fun. I don't know what this. I know there's no one here. They must have, like, scarf art.
That's the outbox for the mail.
Decorative tablecloth with a knot in it. Right, so I've got. Is that the parlor? We're going to the room. Ooh, phone. Look at the phone. Okay, I can't do much with that. Did you even.
Transylvania Telephone Company. Number, please.
Back in 65. Monsignor Briganti.
Just one moment, please.
Those sound too proper,
hello?
Don't they?
International switchboard? Rome for Vladiviste. Rome? Vatican 65. Please hold. You're connected.
This is Cardinal Felicio Briganti.
This is Father Arno Moriani.
Delighted to hear your voice. So, Mr. Devil's Advocate.
Why are we getting called Devil's Advocate?
Stormy. But that doesn't bother me. It gives the countryside a kind of tragic coloring.
My goodness, Arno, you haven't changed. What can I do for you?
I can't remember how to pronounce that. Can I contact? The dude from Alba. Are we going to Eula or Lula? Directly?
No, it's better that I contact them. If
imagine me. The roaming. How expensive is an international call going to be in this day and age? Tell me what the reason is for such haste and investigation of Martha's case.
The Diocese of Alba Eula has known that the canonization of a local native would enable the Catholics, who are in minority in Transylvania, to reaffirm their identity with regard to the Orthodox. This can be very important in a nation under construction. That's why the process began so quickly. Your mission is delicate, Arno. It's difficult to accomplish without offending
someone. Oh, great.
But I have faith in you. You'll know how to act suitably.
Goodbye, Your Eminence.
Only.
Be well, Arno.
Can I go upstairs first? Look at my room. Oh my god, it's weird, 3D. Like moving around. Still seeing a little bit of screen tearing, but.
This must be the room of Janos Peckmester. Smells of tobacco. My next-door neighbor is a heavy smoker. This must be my room.
Next door isn't off, like, is next door, not opposite. Let's go in our room first. It's a little peephole. Ooh, we can lock it. Ooh. It's gonna have some secrets.
This oak wardrobe is very solid.
Okay. Oh.
This oak wardrobe is very solid. This oak wardrobe is very solid.
Is it? Care to see it again?
A missive from the Diocese of Alba Eula. It concerns Martha.
I'm gonna forget that. What's going on with her? A brief Martha Kilogarul. Fucking mess that up every time as well. Biographical data. 1871. Birth in Bucharest of Martha, the offspring of a very old Catholic family. Orphaned at age 10, she was brought up by an unmarried aunt. 1891. She passes an examination organised by the Zizra Foundation and receives a grant to pursue medical studies. 1890. Remember when I was playing Final Fantasy 16 and there was a name I couldn't pronounce? And I think someone you'd done like just a noise for it. Oh. Caligarula. No, Caligarul. Sounds like when an alien tried to pronounce California girl. Oh, yeah. Okay, she successfully... No. Okay, she's the first Romanian woman admitted to the examination for the Royal Hospital internship. In 1899, she successfully passes the experimental physiology qualifying examinations. 1902, while working at the laboratory at the University of Bucharest, an accidental explosion projects concentrated acid on her face. She survives the burns. Nathan of three. After recovering, the left disfigured for life, Martha Caligarul pursues her scientific career while working in a Catholic hospice in Bucharest. Pronounce it like squeak, yeah. She publishes numerous articles in various medical journals. 1906. The V Foundation is a Romanian speaking doctor for its dispensary in Vladiviste, which is at the time in Austro-Hungarian territory. Martha agrees to relocate to the small mountain town. She divides her time between her research and the care given to the local population. 1910. She publishes an article entitled Blood Analysis and Statistics, a new method for the study of hereditary diseases. In 1913, Martha receives the Moultown Prize for her work on use of sodium citrate in blood conservation. That same year, she publishes a remarkable article on the P syndrome in collaboration with Professor Heinrich von Gunkruger, University of Bavaria, an expert of international fame. Oh my god, look at him. Look at this. I love that it looks like actual hands and they've just stuck a fucking face on. It's like, here's a dude in lab coat. It's just Photoshop this on. Miss Martha and Professor von Kruger, after a conference given at the Bucharest Academy of Sciences. Vladiviste, after the counter-offensive of the Central Empires. Mr. Clean, whatever you haven't cleaned. 1915, Martha refuses to leave Vladiviste in spite of the threat of war. 1916, as fighting rages around the village, Martha cares with equal devotion for the combatants of both camps. She traverses the battlefield at the risk of her own life, not worrying about the bullets and the shells that whistle around her. Okay, 1919 to 1920, Martha comes to the aid of Vladiviste's inhabitants who have been harshly tested by the war. February 27th, 1920, exhausted by the tough work that she took upon herself for years, Martha died at her residence. One of her last good deeds was to pay with her own funds the trip to the sea of a sickly child. Her grave is object of immediate devotion. The faithful who go to pray there mention several cases of recovery. It must be noted that Vladiviste is one of the rare Catholic villages in a primarily Orthodox area. The instauration? I'm not even sure what that means. Of an official pilgrimage to Martha's grave would allow the strengthening of the links that unite a religious community. Instauration. Oh god, what's this going to be? What were we after? Instauration. And it's not a straw. Well. Action of restoring something. Renewing. So basically using her grave and trying to renew the pilgrimage and the whole church thing. Okay, Martha posthumously received a medal of the Order of the Star for her conduct during the war. Okay, she seems like an alright. Oh my god, we can enlarge it?
That is not... No. No.
Oh. Her grave is the object of immediate devotion. Oh no, what's that? Is that it then?
This biography cannot be objective, of course.
I thought it was going to make everything a bit bigger.
It's about time I pull those two letters to be like.
All the documents that you find are archived, if necessary, to view them. Wait, where's the Bible? Oh, there's the Bible. Why am I worried? Never in my life would I say where's the Bible. Apart from if it's a game. So we get to see this as well.
Enlarge.
I like that it enlarges the picture as well, not that it's going to do a huge amount. But it's a nice touch. Right, What else have we got? Oh my god, we can actually see ourself in the mirror! And it moves! Holy shit, I didn't expect that. Like, the head's moving that way and I'm looking that way. And up and down? Okay. To be honest, I didn't expect that from a game this old. Because even now, games can't get the mirrors working. Or don't care to. I mean, I know it's only a tiny bit. The analogs zoom enhance. That was it, I think. I can't go any further in the room. I'm just checking to see if there's any hatches. You know what, I'm actually real surprised the game to me looks as decent as it does for game being quite old. It unlocks door first. I'm outside, right. Check for our neighbours. Oh, I can't. What? No. Oh. Can't go any further. Fuck. Right, he could be downstairs in the parlour. Yeah. Even this one! Holy shit! Look at man's face. Oh, look, here's some more terrific scarf wall art. Where's he hiding? Is this... Yeah, was it Janos? No.
I'm Janos Peckmester, assistant professor in the medieval history department at the University of Alba Iulia.
Father Arno Moriani of the Congregation of Rites.
I won't
ask you what
you've
come here for. The whole village is aware of it.
And you? What brings you to Vladiviste?
I'm verifying some locations. Oh, didn't we? They do it. We've been completely wrong. At the Castle of Twilight on the heights near the
village. Castle Twilight.
That must be fascinating. Is the structure well preserved?
Before the war, it was in perfect condition. Unfortunately, it suffered enormously during the 1916 counteroffensive.
Why does this person and the innkeeper lady sound like they're in a different room when they're speaking to me? Seems to have been some fierce fighting. Glad to be safe, or I hope that world peace will grow over all these ruins. Fuck it, fierce fighting.
Just between us, it was a terrible defeat for the Romanian army. Without its allies' help, Romania would never have obtained Transylvania.
I guess I hope a world of peace will grow over all these ruins.
We can hope so.
I was in the war as a priest medic in the Italian army.
Oh.
I was at Asiago and Caporetto.
As for me, I prefer forgetting all those years.
That's the wise thing to do. I wish I could do the same.
Do you want to meet me tomorrow at the Castle of Twilight? You can see the ruins from the village. To get up there, go through the crossroads of the Broken Oak.
That would be a great pleasure.
These games are simply render two copies of the character, but that approach forces you to pre-render a room. You can duplicate the world space too, but then it quickly becomes very resource intensive. Anymore?
Do you want to meet me tomorrow at the Castle of Twilight? You can see the ruins from the village. To get up there, go through the crossroads of the Broken Oak.
That would be a great pleasure.
Nearly, okay, apart from the dude that we are and the fatter priest dude back at the Vatican, everyone sounds really strange. Ooh, sneak peek. Oh! Why the dramatic music? Transylvania, history of a reconquest. New Patriotic Publishing House, Bucharest, 1920. Before the Great War, Transylvania was reduced to the status of a province in the Austro-Hungarian Empire. Though Romanian-speaking, the beautiful region was not attached to the Kingdom of Romania and was suffering under foreign yoke. As the war broke out, Romania naturally chose to ally itself with France and England against the Central Empires, Germany and Austro-Hungary. Early in 1916, the Romanian army had entered Transylvania and took Brasov. The enemy had at its disposal overwhelming means. Germany and Austria responded with forces much greater in number. Our army then executed a strategic withdrawal, punctuated by the battles of the Mariseti and Vladiviste. The latter town was largely destroyed by artillery fire. Castle of Twilight near Vladiviste. Oh, but this theatre of heroic fights where mountain troops distinguished themselves. The last, 1918, saw the final victory of the Romanian army, aided by the heroic legion of Transylvanian volunteers. The unification of Transylvania with Romania was solemnly proclaimed in Alba Iulia on December 1st, 1918. A united nation pushed back without difficulty one last invasion attempt, that of the Bolsheviks in 1919. May our motherland be always great and strong, and may, in the centuries to come, the valleys of Transylvania resound with the echoes of this glorious song. God, are we going to need the song? Awaken, Romanian, shake off thy deadly slumber, induced by criminal tyrannies. Priests raise the cross, because our army is Christian. The motto is liberty, and its goal is holy. We'd rather die in battle than live again enslaved on our ancestral land. Do you think they used actual photographs for some of these?
Don't be fooled. This book is just propaganda. Falkenhayn and Mackensen beat the Romanian army flat out, you see. In December 1915, they entered Bucharest. If it hadn't been for the intervention of France and the Allies, there'd be no more Romania.
detail on the carpet. And the floorboards. I don't know why I'm so amazed a game like this has got so much detail on it. Alright, oh, go over here. Oh. Ball in red and black. Enlarge. Look at these faces. Oh, what is going on with you? It's nice. I actually really like it. I can't remember two or one being as detailed. But it was a couple of years ago that I played those. They benefit pre-rendering static environments. Mmm. Ooh, got a statue thing on the wall. Like, why does that look like... why does that look like a symbol for something? I don't want to see a star sign. Oh, holding out your hand. A cripple. Yeah, crippled. Oh, actually, yeah. Maybe not a star sign then. I was playing something and it has star signs in it, and it was like all the different or did I say star sign constellation? I can't remember what the constellation. What's going on here? You got the blurry factor. Just went swished over the painting. Right. Can't open that. Oh my god. No, no, no. No. It's up to Manel. There's so many. We're just shaking.
The Monte Septa Manal. That's a regional weekly. The issues are bound, classified by year.
Well, this is going to be something we need to look at in the future, isn't it? For the year. Something's going to be in one of these years. There's so many years. Yeah, astrological symbology. Yeah, I used an alchemy a lot.
Huh. Nothing much happened that
year. Is
that
the one at the back? Oh man, do I need to go through every one just in case or something? Look at that hair. Your ear's a bit...
huh.
Small?
Nothing much happened that year.
How long is it taking to read these?
It'd be better for me to focus my research instead of randomly consulting documents.
Like, oh, Broken Oblivion Gate, yeah. This is gonna take far too long.
Nothing much happened that year.
Yeah, no, we're not gonna do that. I wish I could go everywhere, but I can't. Okay. What am I... Priest Grave Dispensary. I don't know if it's daytime or nighttime. You buy if that helps. Where was it though? Well, that's the end of the road there.
Nobody in the streets. What a gloomy atmosphere.
This is... oh my god, oh, the train's left. Back at the train station. Where's your dispensary? Bye. Ding-a-ling.
Come in! It's open!
Ooh.
Come here! I'm in the kitchen!
I'm going
the
in
treatment
here.
Room.
Fuck.
Nothing for me there right now.
Ooh, skull pictures.
Don't stay in that drafty hall.
Hello, miss.
I'm Father
Arno Moriani.
I am Dr. Maria Florescu. Have you come from the Vatican, Father?
Ah, I see that news travels quickly.
In relation to our Resident Evil
is a chatterbox,
big lady.
So, I've learned that you reserved a room at the inn, and that you've come with regard to the canonization of Martha Calogarol.
To be more exact, I'm here to conduct a preliminary inquiry. In fact, I'd like to ask you a few questions in that respect. But
keep us warm.
I hope I'm not bothering you, Doctor.
Looks like you just...
Call me Maria, please. And I'd
Maria.
Be very happy to help.
First name business. We're in. What did you know about Martha?
I've read the research she published. I also know about her through what the villagers say, and from the traces she left in this house. She led an austere life and worked a great deal. Her only distraction was photography.
You good?
All her
That's
equipment
good.
Is still here.
Am I? Getting there. Sometimes, probably, maybe won't be as long for the streams. And I'm not sure what days. It's kind of just going to have to be as and when I can. Oh, she does, doesn't she? Like those bits? We want to show off her light sources. I like the idle animations going on now. I haven't brought you here to work.
I'd wanted to set myself up since the end of my studies, but I didn't have the money to buy a practice. The Vesnicia Foundation offered
Vesnicia.
Me this job after the death of Dr. Calogaro. I accepted it right away. I'm put up, I earn a salary for tending to the poor, and I can develop a small private practice on the side. Don't hesitate to come back if you think I can help you, or I can stop by the inn if you prefer.
You will always be welcome, but please, don't go to the trouble. I'll come by again.
Anything else?
Oh, it's very kind of you to visit me, Father.
I want to look through everything. The window. Pipes. Take. Object to take pot.
This isn't the right time.
Which means there will be a right time.
This isn't the right time.
Which means there also will be a right time. This isn't the correct time to steal cookware.
This isn't the right time.
We're going to hear this a lot, aren't we?
This isn't the right time. This isn't the right time.
I must return after midnight.
This isn't the right time.
So it begins. Where's the doorway? Right, so we've got a doorway that way, or...
The treatment room.
Oh.
Nothing for me there right now.
Right now, which means this isn't the right time. Oh, is it a back door? Time is everything, obviously. Yeah, I know. Is it ever a right time to touch a stranger's single? Oh!
Lie down! I'm sorry. That dog is unbearable.
No, he's not. He's a good watchdog.
You're kind. He's a good dog. His presence is reassuring. He keeps prowlers away, and any cats or foxes who might attack my birds. Fidel! Lie down.
I'm not getting in there. Fidel. Is that not the name of one of the Star Ocean characters? Fidel. Integrity and faithlessness? Oh. The left hand of the jewel. And snarling noises? That from up there?
I thought I saw something move behind that window a while ago. Was I dreaming? The house seems abandoned.
Does that mean there's new objectives? Oh, there's a visit Martha's grave. Parish priest. What the fuck's priest about? Does anything look like a church? A coffin. Ooh, different doggy. Oh, we went right past the building. A revolutionary doggo. The blue extra bar, it's always the right time. I have no idea what time of day it is. You know what? I don't know if we have like a death type thing that can happen. You save. I'm assuming that works. Here in November 1916, 4th and 5th Infantry Divisions, the 3rd Mountain Brigade, and the detachment of the Legion of Transylvanian Volunteers heroically fought against the troops of the Austro-German coalition. May the blue, yellow, and red, the colours of the Romanian nation, forever fly over this blessed land. Is she this way? Oh. Tree's a bit bloody and gnarled and like it's got little claws coming out of it.
Bullet holes. On a battlefield, it's typical that the trees be riddled with shot. However, this oak has traces that seem very recent.
Is there a murder? Can't go that way. Oh. Oh, something's following me. Is that where I'm going? Is that her grave? Probably not, Noon.
The view must be splendid up there, but I'm too tired to climb up. I'll go tomorrow after a good night's sleep.
Really? Really? Our tree murders abound. I still don't know where the church is. Dispensary. Ruins. More ruins. Hotel. Which is a dead end, there's nothing else there. To the train station. Maybe it's where Martha's grave is since we're on about the pilgrimages. Ding ding. The priest not be able to find the church. I would say, oh, Dr. Maria Florescu.
A lovely girl. But she's got a way about her, if you see what I mean. You can tell right off she's not from around here.
What does that mean? A way about her. I was admiring the pictures that decorate her in. Oh, the dance one.
Yeah, they're beautiful, that's for sure. But my late husband said they were just copies, not very valuable.
What about your fantastic scarf art? Oh.
There's no point.
Can I take a leak?
What a delicious looking basket. I see the inn's kitchen lacks for nothing. Which, for that matter, is astonishing in this ruined country.
Guess I'm going to bed then. What has he got to say about her? Oh no, that's me. Hello, dude. I like
to
move forward.
Meet me tomorrow at the Castle of Twilight.
Oh my god, he sounds so
awkward.
You can
see the ruins from the village. You get up there, go through the crossroads of the broken oak.
That would be a great pleasure.
Biscuit of 2 leeks and 14 garlic. There's something else though. There was something else there, but I don't know what it was. I wish I had the enhance out with. Whatever that thing was, the brown thing. Please don't be bread. I'm in the garlic and leeks. Is it bread? Bread, leek, and garlic. Probably some recipe to keep vampires away. Well, is it not a bulb? A garlic bulb? So you're probably making plural the bulb part and not the garlic. Like you had one bulb of garlic, two bulbs, maybe. It's the only way, because I've never heard like you have a garlic. It doesn't sound right. Just saying, there's a garlic. You cut off a bit, but it sounds better than E. I don't know, I'm just, it could be, might not be. Yeah, that was not a room, was it? Nope, that was, oh, this was a room. Where do I go to bed? Where do I sleep? When the fuck do I sleep?
This oak wardrobe is very solid.
Wait, onion? What do you call onion then? What am I doing here? Is it the grave? Contact the parish priest. Contact. Oh! Oh! Like, by phone? Oh, pause. And those gold tapes. Red and yellow. Ah! Pick up. Spinny spin.
Number, please.
I don't know.
Hold the line. You're connected.
This is Cardinal Felicio Briganti.
This is Father Arno Moriani.
Know what I'm looking for,
Mister. Your mission is delicate, Arno. It's difficult to accomplish without offending someone, but I have faith in you. You'll know how to act suitably.
Goodbye, Your Eminence.
Oh.
Be well, Arno.
Oh, you're no use, are you? I've missed something already. Where's your grave? Hey, hold on, hold on. Documents, Bible. At random, no. The random one isn't doing anything for me this time.
I have no business being here. It's not polite to burst in on people this way.
Jam onions. Oh, the silver skins. Chives grass onion. I've only just looked around the town and I'm already stuck. What the fuck, game? There wasn't anything here. Was that the symbol? There. Put your hands up. I'm guessing there's nothing I can get here. Marcus Delinker. Fireplace. Can't go that way. You won't let me take pots. You won't let me go to a grave. I've only got two places I can go to.
It It's not polite to burst in on people this way.
Mm-hmm.
I should ring.
So something was watching me. Somewhere between. Oh, two central figures. You know what? I'll go back. Oh wait, I can see it, can't I? These ones. Right, enhance. Here. I mean.
Don't stay in that drafty hall.
Man and lady. That like a cross type thing? No,
don't
I'm not
stay
sure.
In that drafty hall.
Too good for Kamek. I am Ayla Lix. I'm in a different room, so my setup's a little differently. So I've got a doorway right behind me, nothing to
don't
block
stay
it.
In that drafty hall.
Drafty hall.
Drafty hall.
Oh. Large off.
This isn't the right time.
I mean, that's the right
this
time.
Isn't the right time. This isn't the right time. This isn't the right time.
I'm always delighted to see you.
This isn't the right time.
What the hell?
Adele, lie down.
You won't let me go somewhere. Because... I'm going to go back out to the tree. The inn. Not this tree, different tree. I haven't even been in the game for like that long. I'm already stumped. Are we suddenly knackered? 1916. Do I kind of even look at that? In the books. We call for houses. We've Holland had an emo phase. Books for the years. 1916. Oh my god, I'm gonna need a notepad. What the fuck? Why is there...
Cartridges from a revolver.
Are we getting like shadows or things? Or is that where like the body is supposed to have been? Holding the following cartridge found at the crossroads of the Broken Oak. So is this supposed to be in relation to the shots that were made? Oh god, I need to look everywhere now. Yeah, because it looks like it's on there, but it's not. This thing is snarling as well. We can't go that way.
Bullet holes. On a battlefield, it's typical that the trees be riddled with shot. However, this oak has traces that seem very
recent. I'm kind of glad they impaled. I'm wondering if... Anything else? Oh god, I'm looking at the ground now.
Fragrant flowers, a thorny stem. It's a wild rose bush.
Oh! We're gonna be able to do something at some point with that then. Oh god, we are so pixel hunting.
The view must be splendid up there, but I'm too tired to climb up.
So the shells?
I'll go tomorrow after a good night's sleep.
Is that what I was missing? Oh, there's like a cart track as well. Let's hope the shells are what I was after. I remember what, three people to speak to? Tino? Come as if we need to ring the bell every time we want to speak to her.
The treatment room. Nothing for me there right now.
Father Arno, you'll probably think I'm trivial, but sometimes I get bored in this hole of a village. I think I'd like to see more people. Go out some.
Ooh. What was that?
It's a bowl I use to grind medicinal plants. The old recipes are very useful when you can't get a hold of medicine.
Can't use up her. Well, maybe the dude, because he mentioned about the crossroads, didn't he? I think. I have to be missing something though. I don't think where that was. I'm an umpty. I feel like I was looked that way and that way. Now you grind up this casing for me? Yeah. Is this what I'm after? Oh, going up a hill. Jeez. Is this cemetery? Why do I think we're gonna have a heart attack at some point? Big ass cross up there. Let's see there. Only thing I'm doing here. go through the gates. I'm digging up. Realize Radu Tessador. Claudio Torbesco, 1824-1855. I wonder if that's hers because it's got the candles and everything lit up. Elena Maria, Gorgiou, pray for me for I have sinned. Costin Brutar, I will turn back into dust. Luana Gregoriou, silent for eternity. Cosmin Morariou. Daniela Salva. Oh, related. I think I'm gonna. Oh, wait, there's a dude over there too. I'll go with this one first. David Morariou, you who read this inscription, pray for me, poor sinner. Nothing I've done is worth crying for. My death itself deserves not a single tear. Are very happy these tombstones, aren't they?
Please.
Huh? Look at this red-nosed dude.
How do you do? I'm Father Arno Moriani of the Sacred Congregation.
Oh, I like
the
hat moved. I don't please what?
You're the one come for our Martha. Welcome, Father. I'm Jordan Michu, gravedigger and sexton of the parish.
What? Did you know Dr. Martha Caligaru well?
Sure, I knew her. She was a darn good doctor, with all due respect. And she had guts. She saved a lot of folks during the war.
Which is 7 dwarves,
young Ariel, that everybody was
with.
Sure had an evil eye cast on right. Him and was sure to die. But that ain't all.
Yes?
She works miracles.
Explain that to me.
Weren't for her, I'd have the back all busted. Because, let me tell you, she heals even better since she died. That's why people go to her grave and light candles there.
So she is the one that's up there. I visited Dr. Maria Florescu?
She's real pretty, but as a doctor, don't tell her, Father, but she ain't up to our Martha. She couldn't do anything for my backache, but luckily I leaned on Martha's gravestone and said 3 prayers, and the next day I was cured.
You know who his speech reminds me of? Oh, I can't remember his name. The one that played Fester in, like, Adam's Family Values. And I'm sure there was another one that he was in. The old films. I speak to the parish priest.
Father Gregoriou Nijescu. He left for the south on a cure. He was real tired. Especially after the death of Martha, she helped him a lot with his good works.
So he's not
The bishop
here.
Hasn't found a replacement yet, so once again we got no priest. Like during the war.
Is it possible to contact for Gregoriou?
He left a phone number. Ask for Costanza 135.
Right.
I'll leave you.
Speaks very good English for a Romanian gravedigger in 1920 something.
Well, with all due respect, Father, I gotta move the old ones to make room for the newcomers.
Do you ask where you're moving them? Anything else?
This here is the corner of the Great Plague. These folks been here since 1780, so we can stuff them into a communal grave. They'll keep each other warm.
Oh, great. Thanks for that. Oh, bloody hell. This is our so sweet daughter who lived 5 years and 5 months. Daniel Sibisco, Why slit your belly open, oh mother? Why beat your chest? No one escapes death. I have some questions about these gravestones, because... Yeah. Yeah, my parents celebrated withdrawing my first birthday. But if to be my only one. Memory of T.B. Roman. 1810 to 1813. He lived for 3 years, 1 month, and rest in peace. Wow, are these all the children? So I can... Over here? Ooh. So if I do that and see the objectives... I got the information I needed from him, that's fine.
Here's a wooden church, typical of the region. What luck that the bombing spared it.
So I can't go up there. Still the kid over there as well. Maybe a kid? Tesador Moriaru. May God bring you back to life. I'm skipping some of the names because I'm just going to absolutely butcher them. Paul. Here lies a man skilled in his trade. Imola. My worries have finally come to an end. I rest hereafter well in peace. Got Andre. Temporary is a place in which my body now resides. Lord Daniel, priest of the Catholic Church, dead in 1833. Ionel Roman, or Ionel, pure heart, dead in his prime, killed by doctors. It's very to the point, isn't it? Hey, Jesse G, how you doing? Ozanza. Ozanza? Is that not the name of the woman at the inn? I mean, there could be more than one person with the name, but you know. Marianne Alexandru died gored by his cattle as he was feeding them. Gonciprine, his cold body awaits resurrection, which will make him the companion of saints in the celestial kingdom. Dragon Age Veilguard, I haven't actually seen too much of it. What very little I have seen, it looks good to me. I will be getting back to that after Halloween's over, just because I usually do something in lead up to Halloween with games with a hint of horror to them in some way. I was like, screw it, we'll come back to that, and then after Halloween's over, get it released. I've only just got to the Skyhold in Inquisition. I've got so much more I need to see, plus a DLC. I think is advisable to see before Veilguard. So it's going to be a little ways off for that, I think. I will eventually get it. I knew that I wasn't going to be able to finish it beforehand. I knew some stuff before because like the game's been about for a while. But I don't know a huge amount about it, like the stuff from Inquisition. So it's basically just been little bits here and there that I've seen for Veilguard. So I'm kind of staying away from it for time being. But yeah, there was no way I think I was going to be able to finish it even if things hadn't happened. So the plan was always to do Halloween stuff at some point and then finish Inquisition after it. Praetorian. Radu. I lived a life my own way, pure and honest, without lying or straying from the right path. May this prove good to my bones. Roxana. Thomas and Raquel. Raquel. I can't get in there. Burial plot for sale. Sindhu. I've seen this one already, haven't I? No, I've not. Oh, no, wait. Sindhu? Yeah. Lucien. Here rests an unknown young woman dead in 1919. Killed by lightning in the middle of the night. Julian. Probably for the best. Let's bugs and all. Let me patched first. No, you know what it'll be? I swear to God, if they have to patch in storage and inventory space. You know what's going to happen though? I'll say, oh hey. We'll go from Inquisition to Veilguard, right? But, February. Is that not when Assassin's Creed Shadows moved to? Now, usually every year that it's came out, I do end up getting it at release. Because I'm a glutton for punishment like that. Apart from the year that Unity came out, because it didn't have the PS4, so I got Rogue instead, because that was released at the same time the PS3 and older consoles. I probably had Xbox 360 at the time. So it was like the only year. Well, actually no, and when 3 came out. Okay, 2 years. But every year after Syndicate and onwards, I've had it release. Wow, I messed up saying that. Best to wait for all of Veilguard deals that come out first then. Maybe. The time I get to it, I'm gonna have bloody forgotten everything. The problem is though, I went from 2 in Inquisition. Did I do it straight away? Did I have anything in between? I can't remember. So this will be a nice gap. Playing these games as well. That I don't know how I would feel going from Inquisition right into the Veilguard and knowing there's potentially something else that was on the horizon as well. That you usually get when it comes out. But you know what it is? It was straight after each other. I'm gonna try to make it an easy short now. Possibly. I kind of feel like they lost it with Mirage. They tried to do like the old format and it kind of worked, but it kind of didn't. I don't know why. But if it's shorter, I'm okay with that. Yeah, killed by lightning. Who else? Did we get you? Martinescu. HM. Oh! What did I just do? I remember not noticing you switch games and just thought, man, this area sure looks a lot nicer than the last one. Brilliant. Oh, we get to do something with this. What did it stand for? May this tomb be preserved from a misfortune. Luciana Hartner, 1870. HMDA. There's a kid there.
Hey!
Oh, jeez. This is better than please.
Hello. My name is Ionel.
Hello, son. I am Father Arno.
You're the one who's come to get Martha into heaven?
Oh, I'm not the one who decides that, you know. I'm just here to question people to find out who she was.
Did you know Martha well?
She gave injections. When I was little, that scared
me. It's good look, 77. She gave me candy afterwards. It's the face.
She was nice. And she's even nicer since she's dead.
Is that so?
What?
Explain that to me.
She protects people. When you go to some bad spot in the middle of the night, you have to repeat 3 times, Saint Martha, protect me, and nothing will happen to you. The gravedigger told me that. And also, when you burn a candle on her grave, you can make a wish.
Have you made one?
Like a birthday cake?
I asked Martha to send me a friend to play with. I had one, but he died. And then another one, but he left, so...
Is that the one that got sent to the seashore? Do you know Dr. Maria Florescu?
She's beautiful. You can see she's a lady from the city. She's the one who gives injections now. She gave one to me, but I'm not scared anymore.
Why did we want to speak with you? Paul. There's not a Paul!
I asked Martha to send me a friend to play with. I had one, but he died.
Okay.
And
bye. So this is her grave, I think. Let's have a look here. Here lies Radu. Okay, Claudio. This stele covers a child whom death took away too soon. Was it stele steel? Memory of poor Annie. Perished in a terrible fire. Things to look at. To the regretted Dr. Martha, testimony of the esteem and respect of her colleagues, Bucharest Academy of Sciences. To Martha, Knight of the Star, in honor of her courage and her devotion during the war, Chancellery of the Order. Martha, 1871-1920. To Martha, our guardian angel, the parishioners of Vladiviste. You know, I don't trust any of this. I don't trust any of this. I've got crows flying? Might fry at me. Flying at me. Try the door.
It's closed.
Oh, for fuck's sake. I guess I'll go and phone someone. I can't remember what he said it was. Because we all to be down the hill again. Are we still being followed? Where's my hotel? My inn? I think there's other places that have phones, but I can't remember.
Number, please.
Ooh, Costanza 135.
Please hold. You're connected. Greenleaf Rest Home. Good day.
Could I speak to Father Gregorio Negescu, please?
Oh,
this
Stelly?
This is Father Arno Moriani.
One moment, I'll see.
This is Father Gregorio Negescu.
Hello, this is Father Arno Moriani.
Don't get an image.
I belong to the Sacred Congregation of Rites, and I'm investigating the case of the late Martha Calgaro.
the late Martha what? Oh, how's your health, Father?
Not very good, actually. But what good does it do to talk about it? Prayer is my only comfort.
What did you think of Martha?
She was a good Christian. Courageous, charitable. And she attended Mass regularly. I appreciated her a great deal.
May I ask you without beating about the bush if you consider...
Some of my parishioners think so. The diocese realized that and asked for the case to be opened. Myself, I don't know. Things like that are way beyond me, you know.
Goodbye, Father Gregorio. I wish you a good rest.
Goodbye, Father Arno.
Well, I think I've done enough for this first day at Vlada Viste. It's time to go to bed.
Bedtime? No. I was like, do I recognize this dude who's voicing Arno? He's been in a few things. But I don't know. Is a police officer in Detroit become human? But this is so old, I don't know him. Looks like it seems some shit that didn't ever. Beyond Two Souls as well. Probably I've heard them somewhere else. Could be it. And Heavy Rain. Really? Huh. And Fahrenheit. He also voiced Jonathan Dude in the first two games. Agent guy. Which game? I've seen that many now. This is my room.
Wow, I'm dead tired. Got to go directly to bed.
Oh, just directly, Everine. Oh, I don't know. Maybe? Hmm?
Luciana.
Luciana.
May I come up?
Come.
Next door. Why is there a door there?
I can't believe it. Come. Come to me.
I was never allowed to see this door before. Two figures there. Oh! So we're not actually seeing things as they are. We're seeing their, like, silhouettes doing things? Is that why we've seen the dude impaled?
Free me from night terrors. What a strange nightmare. I think I need to refresh my ideas. What if I went to visit Janos at the castle?
Dagger and mallet. Is this my room? But where's but so it wasn't my room? What are you telling me? Augustianos, Peckmaster, Castle of Twilight. How about consulting the Bible? This was Chisel. Oh, maybe. The word of God can guide or comfort you. Oh, and they rolled a stone against the entrance of the tomb and went away. Ooh. Well, I could see is where you got the documents about. I don't know if I could clean up or anything. Oh, no. Go and see our
Please,
Mr. Man.
Father, I have something to tell you.
Wait, who's that? Okay.
Mr. Stefan Luca, a reporter from the city, arrived Luca. Here this morning. He's in the parlor. He sort of told me to kind of tell you he'd like to talk to you.
A reporter? Very well, I'll go.
Wait, Father. I also wanted to tell you. I have to make up the room to the right of yours for Mr. Luca. And maybe it's dumb, but I don't dare go in it anymore.
Why?
Well, why is that, Ozana?
Well, it's like it was kind of cursed.
Really? What makes you think that?
The spot.
Just a little bit.
Black spot. The more I rub, the less it goes away. And then the crucifix. It falls down on its own.
Come, come. What can I do to reassure you?
Please, put the cross back in place. I don't dare touch it. And bless the room. That way, I'll be able to go in it to do the housework.
Okay. So this one? So there is a door, but our thing's in front of it. Huh. Cross has been upside down.
This bolt was forced a long time ago.
Yeah, the wardrobe we have is on the other side. Upside down cross.
Here's the black spot that frightens Ozana so much.
And that's the blood from what we've seen in his nightmare thing. Oh, Tower of Babel. Enhance. Or enlarge. I'm trying to work out if there's things in these areas. Yeah, it's been upside down. Oh.
Gloria Patri, e Filio, e Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc, et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Okay.
Ozana, I put the crucifix back in place.
Put back a few times.
Are you reassured?
Thank you, Father. Thanks a lot. I'll be able to fix up the room.
Anything else? Ooh, a young boy.
Always hanging around outside, if that ain't a shame. Of course, he's got no more parents. Lives with his uncle, who barely takes care of him.
It's not polite to burst in on people this way.
I've got, ooh, I've got two things. I need to speak with the reporter, dude. The journalist. Does it matter which way around I do things here? Did you try it in reverse? Well, I just wondered how, if it would hang it a different way. Because it's definitely been upside down. Like, it's been knocked off the top bit and then swung around. You know, just try these things. Do I want to speak with him? Okay. Leave it. Oh, they don't switch it to the top.
Father Arno, I was expecting you. Delighted to meet you, Father.
Mustache.
Concerning Martha, I mean Dr. Kalugarl, it's very important that you know. She was murdered.
What are you
saying?
And
do you know how?
Yes. I didn't introduce myself. Stefan Luca.
Journalist.
It's a good thing that you're here. Since the departure of Father Gregorio, this village really needed a priest.
Yet I didn't come to replace him.
Of course, I know why the Vatican has sent you, for Martha's canonization. But I want to talk with you about something else. There's something much more serious. Martha, well, she was killed for defying evil. My God, I should have helped her more. I wrote an article, but he prevented me from publishing it. He's very powerful, you know. Martha was not his first victim.
I'm afraid I don't follow.
Are you skeptical? I was too. But read this letter that Martha sent me 3 months before her death.
Ooh. Oh my God, how the fuck am I supposed to read that? Dr. Martha, dispensary... The attention of Stefan Luca. Okay, sir. Read your last letter with a certain irritation, I must admit. Let's see. People I'm telling you about are afraid to fall asleep, hear voices, walk in their sleep, and present strange stigmata. Finally, and most importantly, die of a devastating and inexplicable... Does it say anemia? Oh my God, let's try and... Anemia. Would you believe that it is simply a matter of nervous affliction? Even Professor von Kruger, so conventional in his approach, admitted that it was something else than a nervous disorder. I'll send you the medical files. Please examine them and you'll change your opinion. Please believe me, a strong force is at work. And I will be in great need of allies to be able to counter it. Sir, please accept my sincerest greetings. Nothing else.
Here are the notes Martha kept. Once you've read the file on each victim, you'll be convinced.
Pick it up, takes out. I know. Medical files. Okay. Marion Brescu Prada. Roadmender. Roadmender. Has lived alone since the death of his wife. Not very sociable, strong, no previous medical history. September 1913. Found unconscious while working near the Broken Oak Crossroads. October, blood analysis. Noted anomaly. Get in touch with Professor von Kruger. Late October, repeated transfusions. The patient declares himself cured. 2 days later, found dead in his bed, drained of blood. I'll start writing an article on the case with Professor von Kruger. I think we have identified a new syndrome, the P anomaly. Professor wishes I begin systematic tests on the town's population. A town of about 5. Celdric Maliscal. Schoolboy, orphan, April 1916. Child complains of nightmares, sleepwalking, a sedative prescribed. June, anemia symptoms observed. Blood test, P anomaly present. Blood transfusions, improvements, then relapses. July, noted hematoma on the neck. I'm very worried. Child held at the dispensary. I seek the help of G. We take all precautions. Alas, I fall asleep during my shift. The child dies. We contact the police. Reply, due to the threat of war, no one is available. No investigation. Unknown young woman. Amnesic. Young woman. Left on the roads by the war. God knows how she arrived in our village. October 1919. I met the young woman close to the cemetery, shivering with cold. I took her to the dispensary, gave her food. Routine test, P anomaly found. I noticed several blue marks, no clear wounds, but strange hematoma on the neck. Police alerted. There was no reaction. G comes to see me. We apply the traditional method, but the young woman leaves as soon as the dispensary surveillance lightens up. She roams aimlessly around the village at night. November. The young woman is found dead at the cemetery near the grave with the wild rosebush, drained of her blood. Police finally come to the scene, but the investigation is botched. Inspector Lupar's conclusion, the victim died of cold. This is shameful. I must do something. Ariel Vulpesco. Rosanna's son. Father dead. Intelligent but spoiled and turbulent. His mother forgives him everything. January 1920, mother concerned, child's not well. Few anomaly detected, test done a few months earlier, did not show anything. I choose not to fight. I send the child to the seaside, far from here. February, good news, the child has recovered, no relapse, he must stay there. I'm happy but still worried. He will be the next victim. I will not be able to send them all away. I must tackle the root of evil. It got so cold, all her blood disappeared. Okay. What's that? What is that you got? What are you tapping? You just tap on the seat.
The documents you showed me are astonishing. However, I'm surprised Dr. Calugaro entrusted you with them. Doctor-patient confidentiality and all.
Medical secrecy is a secondary issue when human lives are at stake. Think of it. The identified victims are just the latest ones. Martha was convinced that there were many others over the past years. No, the past centuries. She wanted me to alert public opinion, but the editors of my paper were pressured. Our enemy is very influential. We have to do something.
Let's see. I agree that these files are very disturbing, but we can't take the place of the police.
Martha contacted them a number of times, to no result.
Perhaps they didn't take her seriously. We should call back to explain the situation calmly.
The police, once again, didn't do their job. Call them, and you'll see.
That would seem to be the most reasonable course, if you don't have any objection.
Go right ahead. The telephone is in the next room. When you realize the ineffectiveness of the police, come back to see me.
You want me to call the police then? Oh, call the police to check the story. Well, I'll do just that. But that's new. That is new, isn't it?
I can't borrow this without permission.
It's a dragon. The fuck? I'm sure that wasn't there before. Ding ding. Your food's gone as well. Can I take your piece of dragon art? May I borrow the dragon you've hung near the telephone?
Sure you can. I don't know where it comes from. Some vagabond brought it to me. I gave him a meal in exchange for
a meal?
It. My way of being
a couple of lilac and 14 garlics. 14 garlics. What are the circumstances of Martha's death?
What I think. She killed herself with work. And anyway, she never ate anything. I always knew her thin as a rail, even before the war. When you work a lot without eating, then obviously...
Blood money! Many strange deaths in this village.
Jesus, Mary and Joseph, oh father, please don't say that. People might think us folks in Vladivostok ain't very proper.
Dragon no mine. Object taken. Wait, what's gone? Why have I only got one cartridge there and no cross? The crucifix I picked up from the floor. Oh no, it's... Oh, for fuck's sake, it's back. Okay, stone fragment with the image of a dragon. You borrowed it from... Your innkeeper, Ozana. Oh, please.
Number, please.
The police.
You want the police?
Yes. Put me through to the police station in charge exclamation of Lata Vista, mark. Please.
Just one moment, please. You're connected.
Provincial police, what is it?
This is Father Moriani. Well, several people died in Lata Vista in mysterious circumstances.
Lata Vista? You have the wrong department. You have to contact the Transylvania Regional Brigade. As for Inspector General Brutar at Alba Eula 22.
Number, please.
Alba Eula 22.
Hold the line.
This is Inspector Brutar.
Hello. This is Father Arno Moriani.
Did you get him about?
I belong to the Sacred Congregation
Kenobi.
Of Rites.
Hello.
I've come to Lata Vista to investigate the case of Martha Caligaro in view of her eventual canonization.
Martha Caligaro? I remember her well. Always bothering my men with unbelievable stories and groundless complaints. She wasn't a bad woman, but she had a screw loose.
I'll note
she's asleep in another room.
I'm calling because my investigation has revealed several suspicious deaths, which all occurred in Lata Vista. They could very well be murders.
Give me the names of the supposed victims.
Marion Marescu, dead in October 1913. Celdric Maliscal in July 1916. And an unidentified young girl who died in November 1919.
I see exactly what you're talking about. Wasn't it a certain Stefan Luca who transmitted this information to you?
Well,
someone
is...
fixed again.
Of course. Don't believe anything he tells you. He's just been fired by his newspaper. He's just a troublemaker. Father Moriani, I have to...
I'll have you know I worked this one out myself with the help of other people on the internet who had the same issues. You know, I took the time to look for a solution.
By certain political groups. So
that counts, right?
If I were in your shoes, I wouldn't prolong my visit to Transylvania.
Thank you for your advice, but you understand that I can't leave without carrying out my mission.
Concerning those deaths I spoke to you about, I have to point out several important facts.
Yeah, go on.
Well, we have three individuals dead in the same region and in the same manner.
Just 3 years apart
blood.
As well.
That would suggest the work of some perverted criminal, wouldn't it?
I was sleeping the whole time she was fixing it.
It would suggest, rather, that your informant is bored and has a fertile imagination.
I mean, reason to think Dr. Martha was murdered?
None.
Did a physician examine her body?
Certainly not. Why bother? Her death wasn't at all suspect.
Goodbye, ooh. Inspector. The police think that Martha was mad.
he didn't even get to say goodbye.
Doesn't look good, but it's out of the question for me to close the file without digging deeper. Let's go back to the journalist to question him.
The journalist? Oh, Jesus. Wait. The dude's waiting for me at the crossroads.
Good. Did you call the police? Are you convinced that they won't do a thing?
Oh, you've
then
got a trunk.
Then we can go on to serious matters. Read these two letters and tell me what you think of them.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Right. Stefan. So your article was rejected? Thank you for your courageous attempt. Alas, we see now that we must find a different solution. I'll speak to you about it in person. To answer your question, please know I was never interested in vampire legends prior to my arrival in Lata Vista. And little Celdric was at his worst. It was our friend G. Do you know who G is? Is that the professor dude? It's not a nice thing to tell people about their notes. where was I? Okay, our friend G, who helped me implement the traditional measures. The garlic and a protective circle. I noticed an improvement until that fateful night when I found the window open, the crumbs of host dispersed by the wind, and the child dead in his bed. Oh. Page 3. How could I, after that, harbour the slightest doubt about the enemy we're fighting? Best wishes, Martha. Dear friend, I thought a lot after our last conversation. Where, then, is the beast hiding? This certainly changed its lair since the war. Even if I knew where it was, I would avoid approaching it directly because it keeps on its guard. There is still the path of the dragon left. Name drop. I am convinced that it will lead me to my goal. I know that you and G do not approve my attentions. No doubt there is danger, but my life is not so precious as to prevent me from risking it for a good cause. I've carefully read the ancient texts regarding our enemy. A few clues lead me to believe that the path begins in Turkey. Plan to go there soon to look for the traces of the dragon. Becoming a ninja? P.S. Upon my return, I'll hand you to you the file that I've put together on the path of the dragon. If something should happen to me, you'll find it in my case. Find the key, carefully observe the order of the paintings on the wall. The order of the paintings on the wall. Oh, great. Which
vampires,
wall?
Hosts?
Which place?
My lord, I must elucidate this sorry affair. Let's subject Stefan Luka to some methodical questioning.
don't wake up. Where's the quarry?
First of all,
I don't know.
What exactly does the term vampire signify?
Vampire?
A ways down the road?
Upir, Upir, Brugalakis for the Greeks. Do these words really evoke nothing for you?
To tell you the truth, they do. I seem to recall reading something about these, creatures. So, if I understand right, Martha tried to drive them back with a communion host ground into a powder?
That's right, with the crumbs from the host. She drew a protective circle.
Tell me, was the host consecrated?
I suppose so.
Did Father Gregorio know that this sort of activity was going on in his parish?
The best would be for you to ask him the question.
Oh, okay, according to you, La Vista is threatened by a vampire in the 20th century?
That's the frightful reality.
And why don't the residents do something to rid themselves of a curse like that?
Because they're resigned and submissive. To vanquish evil, you have to be strong.
Are you quite sure that Martha didn't die a natural death?
She wasn't that old.
Overwork, perhaps?
Come on, she was in perfect health. Just before she died, she was still hiking in the mountains.
Why do you have such a negative opinion of the police?
Since the war, we've changed our nationality and our official language. One thing hasn't varied: the ineffectiveness of the police. Worse, I think they've sold out to our enemy. I have reason to believe they wanted to intimidate Martha, or even worse.
Have you spoken of vampires to Janos Pickmaster, our neighbor?
Yes, we chatted over a glass of Tsuika, our local prune brandy. Janos is a great lad, very cultured, but he has a rare lack of imagination.
Did you speak about this with Dr. Florescu, who took over from Martha?
Young Maria? No, I didn't want to frighten her. I don't think she can help us in any case. Father, help me resume the task that Martha began. With a priest at my side, I'd feel stronger.
It's not so simple. You see, this affair is really not in my purview.
Was that it? Consulting the Bible. Is there anything? Call Father, ask him if he knows. Oh god, I can go see Janos. Are you doing the phone calls? We're here.
I have to question Father Gregorio about this sinister story of vampires.
You lurk from beds. You do need your beauty sleep and lots of it. Alright, Bertharion, hopefully you have a nice sleep. Gregorio? No. Who am I calling?
Number, please.
Costanza?
Please hold. Greenleaf Rest Home. Good day.
Could I speak to Father Gregorio Negescu?
He's going to be dead, isn't he?
This is Father Arno Moriani.
One moment, I'll see.
This is Father Gregorio.
Oh, no, he's not dead.
Hello, this is Father Arno Moriani. Father, I have to discuss a very delicate subject with you. Please, answer my questions very precisely. It's important. Do you know Stefan Luca?
He's a journalist. A friend of Martha's.
Developed photographs?
Photographs together.
According to Stefan Luca, Martha Caligaro believed in vampires and engaged in strange rituals.
It's true. And before you ask the question, yes, I helped her.
You do know the position of the church on this subject, don't you?
I know it. And I don't doubt that it's a very reasonable position when you think about the question seated in an office in Rome. But in Vladoviste, the situation is different.
Do you want me to tell you how things happened?
I went to the dispensary to give extreme unction to Seldrick, a poor child who's wasting away.
Unction. That's a word, isn't it?
Prayers. And then I gave Martha the sacred hosts. She used the wafers to draw a protective circle around the sick boy. Was it sacrilege? You're entitled to think so. But the
just anointing someone with oil or ointment.
Of the transfusions. We had to try everything to drive away the creature. What would you have done in my place?
I know in spite of all your efforts, you weren't able to save Seldrick.
Unfortunately not. 2 nights later, the window opened mysteriously, and the wind blew away the protective circle. Martha found the child dead, with wounds on his neck.
Did you inform the police of Seldrick's death?
A waste of time.
Did Martha call on you for other cases besides Seldrick's?
The war began shortly after.
So this is G.
Death. I left the village to serve as an army chaplain. Upon my return, we tried to save a young amnesia victim. The girl seemed possessed. She ripped off the garlic necklaces that we hung on her neck and left her room every night.
Oh, was that cold? That cold drained her.
She didn't survive long. Young Elliot almost died as well. But Martha saved him by sending him away from the village. It was probably the only thing to do.
Stefan Luca holds that Martha was murdered.
It's very likely. I knew she
a
was
a dog
credited.
To protect her.
I'd offered her a dog to protect her. Now that seems to me to have been laughable. As if a dog could have stopped the enemy she was confronting.
Do you think that enemy was a vampire? A supernatural creature?
An emanation of the devil. If you'd lived a few years in Vladoviste, you wouldn't doubt it.
We heard of the Path of the Dragon?
Martha spoke to me of it. It's a sort of accursed way of the cross, which leads to the source of evil. She embarked upon it against my advice. I wanted to protect her. Oh, I was wrong.
Why is that?
She died fighting. I fled. Today, it is she who has the good part.
Thank you for your frankness, Father. Of course, you realize that after your revelations, Martha will never be canonized.
Yes, of course. What does it matter if she rests in peace?
Another thing. If a direct question is asked, I shall be forced to evoke your part in this business.
So be it. But you should know that my only regret is not to have helped Martha more.
He slipped
the
away.
The Lord is our only judge. I have no wish to condemn you. Goodbye, Father Gregorio. I wish you a good rest.
Goodbye, Father Arno.
All right. Now it's time to make my report to Monsignor Briganti.
No, Nico, sit down. Wait a second. Maybe we are back as well. How do we do this? Menu. Leave. In. Yes. Yes. So I need to tab out this and hopefully it works. Oh my god. You know what? We'll do that one there. I'll get the BR back one on. Alright, we're back. What do you need to do to change this? I have no idea. Get rid of that. Does it work? We good? We good? Returned? There's no crashing! I'm good with that. I need to phone someone. Do I have to do it just now? Briganti. Hey, Jackap, how you doing?
Number, please.
Briganti? Back in 6 to 5. Oh, get a picture. Oh, he's not there. Why do we need a phone if we can see him? I think I need to cancel out of this then.
He's not in his office. I'll call back later. Meanwhile, let's go see Janos at the Castle of Twilight. That will give me something else to think about.
Oh yeah, totally. Something else to think about. The pop on subspace. Oh my god, what is going on? This is morning! Is it not? Do I leave this place again? Is it this way? God, we're so unfit.
According to what Janos told me, the crossroads of the broken oak ought to be here. I have to keep going straight to get up to the castle.
Up there. We still got that. Still got the dudes. Oh, wait, who's this? I wasn't there before. But I can't do anything with it. Maybe in the future. Okay, I've got a question. People have got cats. How do they react around a water bowl? No, he gets fresh water every time he gets meal. Right? And his new thing is, he eats his food. Goes and takes a drink. Starts dipping his paw in the water. Then shakes it. And then looks at the water art he's made on the wall. And investigates it and sniffs it. And he'll go and dip his paw in the water bowl again. And then shake it and see what other paintings he can make with water. And you get like a splash screen. Bonkers. Oh, he'll see things. He thinks there's flies. There's something's been flies about. So any little shadow that's on the ceiling, he thinks is a fly. So he'll look up at the ceiling and he'll just start like screaming at it. I think his teacher's being crazy. Oh, you're not decided was having any of this? He's a totally normal cat, yeah. Now he's just there, like, I'm licking my paw because it's wet. Equally fascinated and revolted by what is normal. Like, I think they do it to test it so it's not, like, stagnant. It's like, you get fresh water every time your food gets put down. And sometimes in between, if you've been fucking making water art out of it and you've made it dirty. Oh, anything new here? No. Is this all the same arrow forward? Oh, hi. Janos? You're spoken.
Hello, Janos.
Welcome to the Castle of Twilight. These ruins are impressive, aren't they? Imagine this edifice before the war, when the erect ramparts had been standing for centuries. The Dragoman family, which reigned over Transylvania
Dragoman.
In the heroic age, lived here. Its most famous member was Vlad Tepes, hero of the war against the Turks.
Okay, who's Vlad?
A magnificent sovereign and a passionate subject to study. I think he's the greatest prince Transylvania ever had.
And oh, your cat would also at times just drink water like that, just licking the paw. Was it Vlad who built the castle built?
No, the building is much older, but Vlad Tepes enlarged it by adding the outer walls.
Was it inhabited before its destruction?
It was lived in until 1900, when the last owner died without any heirs.
B.M.
Or B.M.
That's the abbreviation of an epitaph. Most likely, Boni Memoriae.
I think this inscription was carved to mock those who were lying under the stones of the walls.
Skeletons. Exposed during the destruction of the ramparts.
They were convicts who died of exhaustion while digging the foundation of the castle.
Oh shit.
They were buried where they fell. Probably so their ghost would guard the place.
Okay. Ooh, is that the other part? The dragon to the...
This sundial adorned the entrance to the castle.
Lion?
A bullet shattered it. And a piece is still missing. I searched the whole area without finding it. That's especially annoying. Gold with a sable wolf. The personal coat of arms.
Sable
of
wolf.
Lads
that's not
bench.
A wolf.
Vulnerant omnes, ultima necat. All injure. The last one kills.
That refers to ours, doesn't it?
Yes, which gives us a rather gloomy picture of man's fate.
Dragon. It's the dynastic emblem of Vlad's family. Where did you find it?
A vagabond gave it to Ozana. Perhaps I should return it to her.
No, but its place is here. The person who took it had no right to pillage these ruins.
I must admit, you're right.
No. He's fine. He's good. But he's... So here's the thing, Cobalt, he's not big, right? But he's 7 months old. He is, his weight is nearly the size of an adult, average adult cat. He doesn't look it though. It's all that fur, isn't it? What else we got? All wound, the last one kills. That it? I can't take that back though.
Can you hear? The wolves multiplied during the war. Now that peace has returned, they're hungry.
Well, I'm saving it before they try and chomp me. Go with that one. Anything else, Mr. Johannes? Just to make sure, a little bit pixel hunting. So then we've got a way to go through gates. We looked at that already. There's a tree.
This tree is a Sorbus acuparia, commonly known as the mountain ash.
Just put on mass. Yeah. He doesn't even get the. Oh, I'm sure there's recommended amounts, and he doesn't. He gets like the lower end for his age range to take into consideration, like treats, which isn't a huge amount anyway.
I already have some.
So I wanna go that way. Oh, is it the same way? I don't know, it could be.
These ruins are impressive, aren't they? Imagine this edifice before the war, when the erect
rampart. So you said that before. This way?
The drawbridge is destroyed.
Oh, destroyed? How do we get round?
Frustrating, isn't it? Ah, if only I had the means to restore it.
The castle must have suffered terrible bombing.
Yes. In addition, the Romanian mountain troops had the dubious idea of storing ammunition here. Obviously, the whole thing blew up.
Give me a second. Do-do-do-do-do-do. There we go. We're back on. Okay, so we need to find a way over. Objectives. Call him. Oh, I guess I don't. What was the dialogue he had then? Sorry, ammunition. Whole thing blew up. Right, okay.
These ruins are impressive, aren't they?
No, it's the same. To put that together. Sundial. Dynastic emblem of Vlad Tepes' family. By the castle of Twilight. Enhance. Personal emblem for him. And that's the family one. Okay. What do they need the berries for? I'm going back down the hill. Big ass hill. Where's the town? I'm here. Okay, this is strange. If that's... Unless it's a different way. Oh, we're getting watched again. I'll have nothing to do with those. No. Still nothing there. I like a growling. Head shake him up. I'm stalked everywhere I go in this game. Briganti.
This is Cardinal Felicio Briganti.
This is Father Arno Moriani.
How is your investigation going?
A journalist friend of Martha Caligaro has a strange story to tell. He maintains she was assassinated by a dark power.
What? And what do the police think?
According to them, the reporter is a pathological liar, and Martha wasn't right in the head. As for me, I'm coming to more or less the same conclusions. I have proof that Martha believed in vampires and kept them away with the sacred host.
How could that be? The file seemed so serious. What a disappointment. As for those vampire stories, tell me, was the parish priest aware of this?
I don't know, was he?
Yes.
Was he?
And he did nothing? Said nothing?
Well,
oh, it's Grigori, isn't it?
Don't tell me he took part in these magical rites.
Grigori.
In fact, yes.
Good heavens. And was he paid for that?
I have no reason to think so. He seemed entirely disinterested and sincere to me. And he's very sick.
Well, rest assured that I don't want to incriminate him personally, but we have to react at once, or people will say the Catholic Church encourages superstition. Stay near your phone, please, Arno. I'll make two calls and get right back to you.
Two calls? Oh, that's a bloody ring, isn't it?
Moriani.
Arno, I've informed the Diocese of Alba Iulia.
Diocese.
They're stunned and say it's a setup. Are you sure about what you're putting forth?
The testimony of Father Grigoriou seems conclusive to me.
How could a priest encourage practices of the sort? That's the crux of the matter. I spoke about it upstairs and learned to my consternation that we're not dealing with an isolated instance here. Believe it or not, this is the 20th century and there's a fresh outbreak of belief in vampires. It's probably connected to the success of certain novels that have troubled impressionable minds. And so, I have new instructions for you.
I suppose that I close the Caligaro file then?
Certainly. And you open another one on vampires.
Excuse me?
You heard me right. Study the legend. Demolish it. Prove that it is not based on reality.
Right, okay, that's what I meant.
Report widespread distribution.
Yes, but hasn't the church already taken a position on the question?
To be sure. Benedict XIV formally condemned belief in vampires, but that was 2 centuries ago. It's time to bring his message up to date.
What exactly am I to do?
Seek the origins of the myth, but also pay attention to its literary aspects, its recent manifestations. Show that those phenomena that terrorize the naive are either pure fabrication or have explanations that aren't supernatural. Let me insist on one point, Arno. For your research, it's important that you consult the best scientific experts. We need the authority of a doctor and a historian to support your conclusions.
Do you think that a rational discourse can vanquish superstition?
I know the battle is never definitively won, but it must be fought. I hope that
task doesn't seem too daunting for you?
Not at all. You're entrusting me with an unexpected job, but a very interesting one. I'll get at it without delay.
I'm counting on you.
Village has no priest. Do you think I should celebrate Mass in the church?
It would seem self-evident, but the diocese might object. I'd rather not run the risk. Unless circumstances force you to. If you had to celebrate a funeral Mass, for example.
Goodbye, Your Eminence.
Be well, Arno.
What are we up to now, then? Research on vampires. A historian. Do we know a historian yet? Request the opinion of a doctor or scientist. That could be the Florescu lady. So a historian and a scientist. Or a scientist. Oh, wait, do you have a new Bible verse for this? Keep your word. Told your disciples to cast this demon out and they could not do it. Oh. Remember now. Whoever perished being innocent? Or where were the upright destroyed? For they poured out the blood of saints and prophets, and you've given them blood to drink. They deserve it. Ooh. A historian.
Dr. Florescu came by.
Oh, her.
She asked for you to go to the dispensary because she needs blood donors. If you're so inclined.
Fine, I'll go.
She's the doctor lady. I went to visit the ruins of Castle of Twilight.
Did you like that? Me? I never go up there. Anyway, with my legs, it ain't possible anymore.
I must use science, says the man who believes in God. Do you know if legends about vampires that go around in the village?
Those ain't legends, Father. Begging your pardon. But you shouldn't talk about those things. It brings bad luck. Tell me, Father, do you think Martha will be sanctified?
Do you mean canonized?
Yeah, that's it. I hope she'll be canonized. A saint and a pilgrimage. That's what Blatavista is missing. That'd sure make people come, you know.
I haven't the heart to tell him the truth.
Anything else she'd got to say?
Tell me, Father, do you think Martha will be sanctified?
Canonized? First return, I hope no be more.
Yeah, that's it.
Definitely.
I hope she'll be canonized. A saint.
Do some stuff in the lead up to Halloween.
That's what Blatavista is missing. That'd sure make people come.
Possibly,
you know?
Not tomorrow or Thursday. It should be on Friday. But thank you for watching. Hopefully, you have a nice sleep.
That's the outbox for the mail.
Outbox. God, I'll go and see her then. I'm trying to figure out where she was. Here it is here. And their dog barking.
Hello?
we go in here?
Don't stay in that drafty hall.
Ooh, where is she?
The treatment room.
Can't go in there.
Nothing for me there right now.
What you doing in here? Oh, it's a table. Can I have a look at your
this
drawer?
Isn't the right time.
Sink.
This isn't the right time.
So
this isn't the right time.
What plate? No.
When this isn't the right time.
Oh shit, that's not good. It's supposed to be last Friday you move. Yeah. Are you not sure it'll be this month? Oh, hope you don't have to carry on rehab going at this place when you build.
This isn't the right time.
Can't take your pot either. I'll be like, yes, it's the right time whenever it actually does happen.
This isn't the right time.
The right time for firewood either. Right. Talk to me, lady.
Thank you for stopping by. I noticed that my blood stocks were really insufficient. Would you let me take a sample of yours?
Certainly. I was a priest medic during the war. I saw many lives saved thanks to transfusions.
Oh, so you're a nurse as well. Then you'll be able to do it yourself. Great. I have to rush off to see a patient on the other side of the village.
Oh, what exactly do I have to do?
Draw your blood and place the bottle in the refrigerated chest. The combination is easy to remember. The date the dispensary was built.
1902?
I have to go. Could you mark your blood type in the analysis reports?
I don't know what it
and
is.
Also determine the types of the last three donors? I didn't have time to run the tests. Oh yes, and if the phone rings, please answer.
Why have I turned into your receptionist / medic person?
Alright, down to work. I hope I haven't lost a touch.
But I need to go back outside. Oh no. Oh no. Can I see something first? You gonna have a head off as well? Alright, Von Mulder. Well, thank you for dropping by. Hopefully you have a nice sleep. Rest of your day. Getting out a trusty notepad because I'm gonna forget all of these things. Where are we? Why have I got Skingrad just outside? Kvetch. Was this my list of Oblivion gates that I'd done? I think it might have been. I know I need a pen. There we go. I've got one. Tell them the right type. Don't kill any patients. Well, in 1805, I was wrong with that. Nope, I'm so wrong with that. Oh, got the date. What else do I need to do here? You know what? I keep going to press escape from the menus. Nothing is done with the keyboard right now, as far as I'm aware. Save. Castle. Yes. Yes. Return. Ooh, what's that? I'm supposed to draw blood, but I'm reading her diaries. Okay, the P anomaly, study of an atypical form of anemia. Dr. M. Calogaro and Professor H. Is it von Kruger? Summary of case study, patients, family, history, symptoms, test results. Test analysis, decrease the numbers of. I can't even read that properly. Is that granulocytes? This equilibrium in their distribution, new syndrome, the P anomaly, bidimensional aspect, probable influences, influence of hereditary factors, Treatment, blood transfusions. Temporary improvements caused by the blood transfusions. Use of the... let's say, Huston procedure? Usage of sodium citrate as anticoagulant. Progress. Patient relapse. Outcome fatal. Perspectives. Formalization of a test procedure. Statistical study of the disease. Vivo Revival. I don't know. September 1913. Is it the same? Any others?
The Descent of Man by Charles Darwin.
What about you? I have no idea which ones I've read and which ones I haven't now. Like, I don't know if the first one was the first one.
Excerpt from the Medical Chronicles of the Bucharest Royal Academy.
Okay, Sir Dornan.
Treatise on Statistics, Theory and Practice.
Fourth one.
Exercitatio Anatomica de Mortu Cordis et Sanguinis in Animalibus. A reprint of the famous book by William Harvey, who discovered in 1629 the circulation of blood. Statistical demonstration on the utility of a sepsis in the operating room.
Sepsis.
To think that 30 years ago, surgeons operated without even washing their hands.
Oh, geez, no. That sounds horrible. I don't know if this is the one that I had already had or not.
Surgery during the Great War, with an appendix on the Albert Houston method.
Houston.
And Dr. Jean Brau's research.
Don't fill the room, it's deadly. Hey, I can only press whatever the game lets me press, okay?
A volume in German. It concerns the discovery of blood types by Karl Landsteiner.
This one here?
Spontaneous Generation, The End of a Myth. That's a look back at Pasteur's revolution.
Right, we have... medical
instruments? I have to sterilize this equipment before I use it.
Well, for me that's gonna be like... the whole war. Refrigerated cabinet. Ooh, test results. Got that right.
The door of the refrigerated cabinet mustn't stay open too long.
Got two reagents. Got a glass plate.
First, I have to wash my hands with soap. Never handle medical equipment with dirty hands. During the war, I saw far too many comrades die from infected wounds.
Okay. very aggressive hand in the soap stuff going on. Oh god, what am I doing this now? Now what am I doing with it? Got all of my blood in place in the refrigerator cabinet. Wait, give me a second, I'll be right back. The cult's been a little shit. Okay, let's see what we're doing here. What did I say? Did I say that? Give me a second. I need to documents. Medical files? No, it's not. P syndrome. That one. Granulocytes. You need to be neutralized. Main. Okay, I was filling it up, putting the water on there. That's going to boil, I'm guessing. Ah. Any more? Oh, for fuck's sake, the phone's going as well, though.
This is Father Arno Moriani. Dr. Florescu has gone out. May I take a message?
Please ask him to call me back as soon as possible at Munich 321-941.
I'll be sure to do that. Goodbye, Professor.
Goodbye, Father.
321-941. I'm writing it down. Don't know if I need it or not. Wait, wasn't here. Right, I need to be right back because Cobalt's trying to climb the bloody side of the headboard. Right. Right. Okay, should be back now. I had to put him in the hallway. That is heat up there. Medical instruments? There's a handle which allows it to easily place in a pot with boiling water for sterilization. Purposes.
It's not hot enough to boil the water.
Sake. How do I get rid of this? Oh my god. How do I get rid of this? There we go. Let me out. I didn't wash them. And apparently we were touching firewood.
First, I have to wash my hands with soap.
Again. Wash them in another room. Washing hands with gusto. Oh, copper wire. Don't know what I need that for.
Besides three tins of canned food,
There's nothing to eat in this kitchen. Maria really eats like a bird.
It's supposed to mean... back down.
First, I have to wash my hands with soap.
Any fucking skin left the time I'm done with this? Dagwin will scrum to the bitch's sunscreen. No idea what order I need to do anything in. Cotton. What is this for? I was measuring cap. What is that? I've not been told how to use these. On the cell or something. Maybe a sampling stock should a vampire. I'm just gonna have to go around the arm somewhere. How do we get my arm in view? Do this on myself.
First, I have to wash my hands with soap.
Oh my god, it's because I touched something else.
First, I have to wash my hands with soap.
I'm assuming I'll put it onto the slide. Oh, hold on, place it in the refrigerator cabinet. Car open, she's crashing, she's dying. No, I need to collect my own blood, but I... No idea what needs to join anything because I have no instructions. Oh, what's that? Take a funnel. Oh great, now I need to wash my hands again. Hands are washed again. Well, I'm assuming these are things that need to be done. So I think it connects. Oh, I'm an empty.
I've done this hundreds of times to other people, but giving yourself a shot is not the same thing.
It was the bloody connections I was missing.
Ouch!
Damn it.
I missed the vein.
Oh, it's moving! Oops.
That's the right place. All that's left to do is press the needle deep into the vein.
Work.
Blood's not flowing.
Okay.
The ampoule is full. Perfect.
What shit am I doing here? Oh, number 814.
Now I have to store the bottle of blood in the refrigerated cabinet.
814. 14.
Now I have to figure out my blood type, as well as that of the three last donors, and update the analysis reports.
Right. However, I'm going to leave it here and continue this next time I'm streaming. The blood type down. I've not got to that point yet. I need to save this. Save the session. Dispensary. Yes. Okay. Well, that was it for tonight's stream. I'm glad it's working. I did really want to play this, and I've got... This is the third game. I don't know how I'm going to do it. So I'm just going to quickly jump out just so I can see something. So I've saved it here. This will be the end for it. And I'm going to tab out and put that on so you guys can't see my desktop. Because I'm looking at... What else have we got? That was the third Dracula game. Potentially after this, I could go with... Dracula 4 and Dracula 5. I've also got the Barrow Hill, two of those games. I'm eyeing up... Oh, actually, no, I've got Penumbra Requiem. That isn't desktop, that's just the image, so you guys can't see the desktop. Got Fahrenheit. And then my cart, I have... This is what I was meaning about GOG sending emails earlier. In my cart, I've got Darkfall 3 Lost Souls. So I don't know if it's similar to the first one, because I think it's like the same location. Sherlock Holmes, The Awakened 2008 version. And Dracula Origin. Nope, bad games. So I don't know what I'm going to go with yet. But those three are on offer. So, like, cheap to get them. But there's some options. But no, I'm not going with... I've done all of the Dark Pictures Anthologies ones that are available. The Quarry doesn't count. You don't like what? My fantastic choice in Halloween games. But yeah, that is I've got some choices to make. No, I'm not playing Dark Anthologies, because I've played them already. Right, so I'm not quite sure when I'll next be on. Normally I'm off on Wednesday, but I can only be off on the Thursday. So I've no idea about tomorrow. Definitely not on Thursday. We'll be back on Friday, I think. But I'll be continuing this. I'm enjoying it. It's making me work for it though. Bloody point and clicks. If niece when goes to bed after she goes to bed. Play when she goes to bed. What's what I am doing? It wouldn't make a difference whether she was up or not, though. Because so many people in the game. Zero. I probably was zero so many. They were dead before I got here. Right. That's me. So thank you everyone for watching. It's always appreciated. I'm glad we got everything back working. Everything connected fine. Everything, the game's running so smooth. But yeah, so thank you all. I hope you're all doing well, and I may see you soon. Thank you all. Good night.